The Saints Row series is an open-world crime series which at first looks like your typical run-of-the-mill GTA 3 clone, only for the story of the game to become more like a crime dramedy from using guns with bullets to oversized fists that can destroy cars. The series so far have 4 games under its belt, with the upcoming Get Out of Hell as the 5th console game despite being an expansion of Saints Row 4. Anyway, the game I'm about to review is Saints Row the 3rd. I skipped the first two since I don't own a copy of each game, but I saw the cutscenes and gameplay footage to understand the story before the 3rd. In the 3rd, the 3rd Street Saints, after reclaiming Stillwater from 3 new gangs that nearly took down and made peace with the Altair Corporation, became international celebrities thanks to a merger with Altair, effectively turning it into a media group with extremely good publicity. The game starts out with the Saints boss, Shawnee, and Johnny, along with the method actor Josh Burke, planning to rob a bank in Stillwater, only for it to fail and Saints getting captured due to the fact that the bank is owned by the super gang from Steelport called the Syndicate. After a failed negotiation, boss and Shawnee escaped, with Johnny staying behind to cover their escape. After that, Saints decide to avenge Johnny by bringing the fight to the Syndicate in Steelport, gaining new allies and the US government taking notice of the rising crime rate in Steelport and sent in the Stag to put a stop to the gang war. The gameplay is similar to the previous games, with the customizable boss and weapons upgrade to the GTA 3 style gameplay and city takeovers, with a few differences as it can only be done in a variety of different ways, from completing activities, taking out smaller gangs and buying property, cribs and stores, as opposed to completing story missions and taking over strongholds. The main story missions takes you into a variety of situations, from taking down gang operations to fighting in cyberspace. As mentioned earlier, the weapons throughout the game range from guns to oversized fists and so on. The driving and flying mechanics are pretty much standard, except in flying vehicles with weapons on them, which you have to aim and fire, or if you're using a vehicle with multiple modes, fly and fire away. The boss can be upgraded by gaining respect from killing gang members, doing crazy stunts in vehicles, blowing stuff up, etc. with each level up. If you have enough money, you can learn new skills so you can use stronger weapons, carry more ammo, etc. The game have 3 story DLCs. First we got Gangsters in Space, which takes place in between the canon path and the ending. The story begins when a boss got a call from the director who wanted them to star in a sci-fi movie based on Johnny's comic. However, the director is not what he seems. And the boss meets their co-star Jenny and befriends her during the entire movie shoot. The second DLC is Gangibo 7, which the boss participates in a mass murder game show special involving killing mascots and non-fans of the show. Since Gangibo 7 can be finished at any time as it is a special event, not a story outright. The final DLC, The Trouble with Clones, have the boss and Pierce trying to stop a clone of Johnny, who only remembers the events of Saints Row 2, from going on a rampage. It should be noted that the superpower concept used in the final mission of the DLC gets carried over to the next game. If you finish the DLCs all the way through, you'll unlock new homies, gang configurations, and new vehicles for use in the main game. The game is actually fun, but however, after being the trouble with clones, it makes you want to play the game with superpowers. Even with the cheats on, it just doesn't feel right if you have invulnerability, but still using guns. However, the story is a nice change from the crime drama of the first two games, as the series went into the crime dramedy genre of storytelling, making lots of laughs while being dramatic as well. I recommend playing if you want to try the last realistic style Saints Row game before it became a sci-fi dramedy.
What do you mean don't freak out? Do you have a plan?
If I shoot out the window, I can land inside it, cap Philippe, then jump out the back.
You mean we, right?
I'll be back in a minute.
Wait, what?
Shoot out the window? The fuck was I thinking?